justice and judgment.
Go ahead.
And equity.
Go ahead.
To give subtlety. To
subtlety. Subtlety. To be slick.
Mm-hmm.
You think Paul wasn't slick when he got in that jam? Didn't he put the Sadducees? Didn't he pit the Pharisees against the Sadducees?
Yeah, yeah.
Didn't he pit them? He said, "Hey, hold on." But the resurrection, he knew his boys was gonna have his back on that. He pit that against him. Man, when he got into that shit with the fucking, when he got into that thing with the Romans and whatnot, he said, "Hey, you can be the Roman fuck." I'm a Roman citizen. Well, I thought that was against the law. Oh, boy. Just the dude, like, what? Hold on. Did you buy your freedom? No, I was born free, motherfucker. Oh, shit. Oh, we fucking up. Slick. Understanding who you dealing with.
We even deal with Daniel when he was rebuilding the train. Daniel, he put the ashes on the floor to make sure the king.
He was feeding a bunch of motherfuckers. Right.
Oh, foolish king.
He said, "Oh, foolish king," because he didn't see Daniel do that. Daniel only did it to make sure nobody would come in and eat the food that he left out for Baal.
Daniel knew somebody. Yeah. Daniel knew somebody was coming in here.
I told the dude, "Hey, throw ashes on that motherfucker so we can see them footsteps." All right?
Come.
He said, "Hey."
So this is about, if y'all was supposed to be so smart, so street savvy, you were supposed to be able to take your street savvy and now understand how it actually lined up here. The shit that was bullshit, you threw it away. The other stuff that actually made sense, they were kind of used, and you able to balance it because you know you're dealing with slick motherfuckers out here in the street. And you and it says, what's the scripture where it say? They are wiser than Daniel.
Oh, they are wiser.
So you dealing with motherfuckers now that are wiser than Daniel. So you supposed to understand that and always have your guard up dealing with these Shemites. Read.
Jacob, just like like Dragon Ball Z, Super Saiyan. All Saiyans can turn Super Saiyan. It's in you. You just gotta tap into it.
Though he be humble himself and go grouchy, yet take good heed and be aware of him.
Be aware of him. Yeah. Hold on, real quick. This ain't. Though he be humble himself.
Yeah, so
you
heard
go,
that.
He gonna be slick.
That motherfucker, bro. Watch a lot of videos.
Yep.
You be seeing the other Akio trying to wake up Jake. The motherfucking Esau come up. I'm not
kidding. Yes, and you know he's talking to the guys on some other land.
And the I fucking Jake will leave with him like y'all finna go and eat some fucking. Y'all finna go to eat some pizza or some shit. Like y'all know each other and shit.
I can remember one where my lawyer was. I mean, he was ripping motherfuckers in the asshole. This white boy went and got some cookies and came back. You know the motherfucking cookie that white boy brought back.
Man, fuck that.
You know, tell him what he did to them damn cookies. Exactly. That's goddamn eat them.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Them land. So you don't know, man.
And thou shalt be unto him as if thou hast wiped a looking glass.
Yep.
And thou shalt know that his breast hath not been altogether wiped away.
Yeah.
So this Edomite is always going to be this Edomite. He was built and designed to bullshit you, fuck you over, bend your ass over, and trick your ass in every motherfucking country.
You know why I like this one?
Red is brown as color. So you ain't even supposed to try. You ain't supposed to be in cahoots with this. So bringing out, coming out of Egypt, coming out the mindset. Okay, they gonna put all this shit in front of you and make you think that it's so good and whatnot. You'll block them two ways. You'll block one, not that. you're not supposed to trust this Esau and all the crew that the hook to him.
Yeah.
The Moabites, the Ammonites, Ham, all these motherfuckers are hooked to this
Yeah.
Answer. That's why all I'm gonna be mad at his ass.
Yeah, Crafty Council, huh? They tell you that they have the form of Crafty Council, so these other nations is hand in hand with Esau, man. So they're gonna do is the same thing Esau do, man. That's why you have some other nations wearing suits and ties, just like the so-called white people.
Yeah, right? Japanese motherfuckers are doing it, man. They don't wear the kimonos and all that
other kind of shit. 100% whatever type of material that they make, man.
Yeah.
Her suit and tie to go meet the president and everything.
Right.
Hold on, wait before you go. Can you give me in the Psalms 10?
Oh, fuck you, bro.
Can you give me the Psalms 10?
Yeah, come on. I got it for you.
Go ahead.
But no, you just ain't supposed to be trusting your enemy. So in a nutshell, well, look, the scripture tell you that you can be counted wise sometimes. If you can just hold your tongue.
Even a fool was counted wise. We should have forget
to be. So all you got to do sometimes is hold your tongue. If you can, if the scripture ain't in you to know when a motherfucker is saying something fucked up, sometimes all you got to do is just hold your tongue and sit back and fall back. You ain't got to be the first motherfucker to jump on the bandwagon with the shit. Just fall back and whatnot and just read or meditate. Pray for understanding. Sometimes you can go on the scripture and the Lord will give you a couple of scriptures to show you that shit was fucked up and all.
Said him not by thee, lest when he have overthrown thee, he stand up in thy place.
Okay, so cuz haven't Esau had enough of his run? His run is coming to an end. So now why would you jump on his bandwagon and move away from being part of what we hoping to be, part of the elect, hopefully one of the 144,000. We can't count ourselves among that number, but we can hope for it. That's that hope.
Blessed the covetousness who the Lord abhors. That goes back to gain is godliness, man. They think the Lord dealing with you by the shit you got.
Can you hold a sign up over the brothers?
The wicked, do the pride of his countenance.
Go get one.
Will not seek after Yahweh.
Go get one.
Yahweh is not in all his thoughts.
See, Yahweh is not in all his thoughts, man. See, the white man's not concerned about what Yahweh thinks, man. He's just trying to concern about his agenda. He's trying to keep to his agenda. Go ahead.
His ways are always grievous.
Uh-huh.
Thy judgments are far above out of his sight.
Uh-huh.
As far
as he don't think judgment is coming to himself, all right? Go ahead.
And his way is always fucking grievous, man. Taxes. It's like every time you look around, it's like, goddamn, another law taking away the guns and shit.
Impressive.
Letting fucking faggots raise your kids like was brought up earlier. His ways is always something that this motherfucker bring up. It'd be grievous, you just be thinking like, oh, can't do that no more. They just changed the law.
Yep.
It'd be small shit, man.
Look, that was a female. Oh, the brothers saw a female on, I guess, Facebook or whatever, and they took a picture of it and put it on Groupie so we could see what she was saying.
Yeah.
A motherfucker made $400-something, and he had $50 left over by the $400 for him child. He's got to figure out how he's going to live on $50 or whatever amount of time that was. I don't know if he gets paid every week or not. They cracked his ass for $400. But it says that if you don't want to be bothered with a woman,
that's a spirit,
you fuck man sitting on the way and you keep your kid.
Mm-hmm.
You
know? That's exactly. Wicked.
I'm gonna say, me to keep my son already. My daughter, I'm already.
So all this child support shit, man, is wicked as a fuck, man. And here was the kicker. She said she watched the bitch put that $400 up her nose. Go ahead, breathe. I don't want to put that out there. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Thy judgments are far above out of his sight. As for all his enemies, he puffeth at them.
Uh-huh.
He hath said in his heart, I shall not be moved.
See, man, going back to that pride you saw, God, I ain't gonna be moved. I'm God.
He there.
Yeah.
For I shall never be an adversary.
Uh-huh.
His mouth was full of cursing,
uh-huh.
And his deceit is brought under his tongue. Mischief and vanity.
All the doctrines he's coming out with. Go ahead. I bet you that flat earth doctrine, I bet you that came from the American, man. I bet you that came from the white man, right?
Of course it did.
I bet you can go overseas and talk about the flat earth, they look at you like you fucking insane, right?
Like I said, man, motherfuckers get up every morning flying to and coming from Japan and China. They done just came from the other furthest part of the earth. That's why Elder Taha said, you motherfuckers in California, y'all must have been able to see the ends of the earth and take a picture. I mean, just considering that if China and whatnot supposed to be the farthest east you can go, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then that means California and Hawaii and whatnot should be the farthest west you can go.
Yep.
You're supposed to be able to take a picture and see the flat flat earth.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. If the earth was a dome, you should be able to take a plane, go there, and actually ride alone the flat earth and take pictures.
Yeah.
I was getting in the lion game.
He sit up in the lurking places of the villages.
Uh-huh.
In the secret places, who if he murder the innocent, his eyes are privity set against the poor.
Uh-huh.
He lieth and waits secretly as a lion.
See, as a lion, back to that crouching again. Go ahead.
And one of the ways he do that, Salakia, one of the ways he do that, some of these laws he come up with, the name of it, will not have you think about the action of it, like the No Child Left Behind.
Exactly, right.
Well, oh, yeah, No Child Left Behind, we're going to get them all diplomas. Then it'll be like, man, they just pass them dumb motherfuckers through, man. Them motherfuckers ain't
going to be able to do anything.
They want them dumb. Why they want them dumb? So when they go to pull all this bullshit, a motherfucker ain't able to read.
Right.
Mm-hmm. He can't understand what the fuck's going on. You look, man, you know, incognito, man, he read this shit. He got what's going on. You won't get anything. He can't even read the damn thing.
Right. Yep. Back in the shop, man, I felt the second grade I had to do it over, man. But that's back because they said what? He wasn't ready for the third grade, alright?
Okay.
Alright, that's basically all I want to do, man.
I had something earlier, man. When the brothers brought out, they said the heathens took we was talking about the enemy scripture. What scripture was that? Never trust thy enemy.
Never trust thy enemy. So out there.
Yeah. And he was talking about like all the nations took crafty counsel.
Yeah, you
now, this is I'm gonna go to the book of Judah real quick. It's like some history.
It don't matter.
Some history, our history coming out the mouth of the heathens. Check out what they say. It says
three.
This is Judah. In the Apocrypha, chapter 5, I'm going to start at verse 1. It says, then was it declared to Holofernes, is a Babylonian general, the chief captain of the army of Assur, that the children of Israel had prepared for war and had shut up the passages of the hill country and had fortified all the tops of the high hills and had laid impediments in the Champagne country.
You know Family Dollar right down the street, right? Okay.
Wherewith he was very angry and called all the princes of Moab and the captains of Ammon, and all the governors of the seacoast. And he said unto them, tell me now, ye sons of Canaan, who this people is that dwelleth in the hill country, and what are the cities that they inhabit?